All right, day three of my trophy perch hunt. I bagged a couple of master angler perch yesterday. In the same spot today, I found a drop-off in the lake where the perch are staging pretty heavily and schooling up in good-sized jumbo size, you know, averaging, I don't know, 12 and a half probably, but I'm getting some over 14, so just looking for one that hits 15. I'm getting serious today. I have some medium shiners, and if that doesn't work out, I have the nightcrawlers that were working the last couple days. Show you the rig quick. Got three-way slip sinker rigs, basically. Size 4 aberdeen hook, and then a fluoro leader, a 6-pound test, and then a size 18 barrel swivel, and then a sliding barrel swivel going up the main line, and a drop leader of lighter mono, so the weight breaks off first, and then that's connected to the weight, of course. I have three of these out all day, right in the staging area. I'm going to start with shiners at first. There we go. First fish. Oh, that's a nice perch. Awesome. That's what I'm looking for. Nice, beautiful jumbos. That is a beauty right there. Absolute beauty. First fish is not a bad jumbo at all. Right around 14 probably. 13, at least 13 and a half for sure. Got him. Feels like a perch. Doing the little head shakes. Feels like a good one. It's not a bad jumbo at all. Sweet. Not bad. Last one I got on Nightcrawler, and this one too. They're hitting them better in shiners. I might try drifting a shiner, but that's a solid 12. 13.7 and then a one right around 12. Getting hits on the shiner finally. There we go. Got him. Awesome. Hoping for a really big perch. I want a CPR, a 15, 16, 17 incher. And this must be a walleye. It feels heavy. Must be. This is a perch, I'll cry. That's the cool thing about shiners is you just get game fish pretty much. Oh, this is a big fish. What the heck? I'm very surprised. Yeah, it's a big old walleye. Wow! Yeah, look at that. Mamba walleye. Oh my gosh. That's one of the biggest walleyes I've caught in a while. That is a big guy. Wow, get a quick measurement on him and then let him go. That's a nice walleye right there. Feels like another perch. Awesome. Definitely not the 15, 16, 17 I'm looking for though. But still a nice one. Well, decent, you know. Probably double digits. Maybe a 10 incher or 10 and a quarter. Not that big, but it's still a perch. Feels bigger. Might be a bullhead. Might be. Eventually today I'll probably start hooking into bullheads. It seemed like yesterday they started hitting around noon, which was weird, but that's the way it worked out. So. Feels pretty big. This is a perch, it's a monster. I think it's a bullhead. Oh, maybe it's a sucker. Yep, it's a sucker. Weird. hung up on the branches there. Shoot. Get off the branches. There we go. Awesome. Oh, grab him here. Not a bad sucker at all. Pretty good size one. Got all wound up in all my lines. Shoot. Cut him off there. He ate it pretty good. Got my line off. I hate it when braid gets tangled. It's so hard to untangle it. Feels like a perch, maybe? I've seen like 10 groups of people drive into the bays in the last few days and get skunked. Completely skunked and give up. It's all about the structure right now. Water's still cold. And they aren't moving in yet. It seems like to spawn. They're just staging. Nice jumbo. Another beauty. All wrapped up in the line. Yeah. Probably a 11 incher. Yep. Feels kind of like a perch. Wiggling a little. I'm getting them on the 15s. 15 minute cycles. Another nice jumbo. Not bad at all. Oh man, fat quality perch. Get him by the mouth here. Get a good hold on him. Definitely 11 and a half plus. 11 and a half, 11 three quarters. Last one was like 11.4. It's a solid one. There he is. Feels like a perch. Buckle this down a little. I lied. It felt like a perch, but it isn't. Just doing some little head shakes, but I think it's a bullhead they're starting to hit. Maybe. Or no, another sucker. Man, I guess they're a little off. They both looked brown, so when it rolled, I thought it was another big brown bullhead. Big old sucker. Not a bad one. Look how every fish so far has been a quality fish for 3 days straight, pretty much. I've gotten, like, maybe like 3 or 4% of the fish have been small fish. And the rest have been just nice ones, you know? Like, look at this sucker. This is a great sucker. Skinny, but long, you know, well above average in length. There we go. That might be a big perch. It's wiggling its head a lot. Doesn't feel like a sucker. If it is, it's a really tiny sucker. And yeah, nice perch. Awesome. Quality jumbo again. That's a nice one. Definitely 12 or a little over 12. There he is. Nice perch. Awesome. So many jumbo stacked up here. Yep. Probably right around 11 and a half. Beauty. This fish just took it and bent the rod over, so I had to grab it quick before I turned the camera on. I just went whoosh, while it was sitting in the Y stick. Just stayed there. Might be a bullhead. I don't know. We'll have to see. Something that really meant it. He was determined. Yep, first bullhead of the day. Cool. Bring him over here. Not a bad one. Nice, decent bullhead. Probably a 15 and a half. There we go. Been a while since I hooked up with a perch. hours. Bite really slowed down, it seems like. But I might heat back up. Oh, this isn't even a perch. Just something as small as a perch, a little fallfish. Weird. Really weird. Pretty neat though. There we go. That's a heavier fish. Bullhead, sucker, something like that. Don't get tangled in my other line, please. Just go under it. He kind of took it sideways. Yeah, bullhead. Looks like a bullhead. Yep. That's gonna hit two now. That one's more important. This one's a shiner. What the heck? That was weird. Okay. I don't know why I missed that hit. That's bizarre. It was, the pole tip was bobbing. Yeah, if that one gets a hit, it's a game fish. So, this is just another bullhead though. Around the same size as the last one, 15 and a half-ish. Getting hits on the shiner again. Got him. Got him this time. Must have pulled out of his mouth last time or something. I don't understand that exactly, but these are these, I don't want to say probably, but they might just be walleye hits. I saw a walleye chase it in when I was reeling it in one time. I got that 24 inch change earlier. Maybe. Or it could be a bullhead. Eating my shiner. Wow, it is. That's strange. Not crazy, but it is a little weird. Yeah. Small bullhead. Might be a skinny 15. Maybe. Make sure he eats the whole thing. Got him. Awesome. Another fish on the shiner. Feels pretty good. Bigger. Probably not a perch. Just too heavy, you know. Very unlikely it's a perch. Probably a walleye or a bullhead. I would guess walleye, but what do I know? Oh, it looks big. Big walleye. Holy shoot. Another big walleye. They're, you know, pretty big, good size. Wow. Second one of the day. Over 20. That is another nice walleye. Not skinny, but, you know, low to mid 20s. Probably a 23, I'd guess. Yeah, I feel him, he's there. There we go. That doesn't feel like a half bad fish either. It's another nice walleye, wow. Not as big, but not bad. Surprised I'm not getting any perch on the shiners. Crazy. There we go. Got him. Smaller fish. Maybe I finally got a perch on a shiner today. Well, maybe not. Feels heavy now. Oh, another walleye. I felt smaller pulling them in at first. Not a very big walleye, but not as big as the others. Yeah, it's a there we go. Move spots for a bit. Got a fish on. Sweet. Feels good sized. Might be a carp. Feels like a carp. Not sure though. Yeah, it's probably a carp. This line's so dirty, so it's gonna abrade eventually. Unless going through these guides. I think it's okay right now, but it is dirty. Oh boy. Either just cross this line or this one's gonna hit too. It looks like you crossed the line. Definitely. Gonna have a tangle then. Yep, I found a carp swamp. I might go back to the other spot. This sucks. I want carp, I want panfish. Slowly easing them in here. Probably isn't that big. Probably decent at best. Odds are. Isn't spooling me like a monster. That's for sure. See, what am I gonna do? There's a ledge here, so I can't beach them. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I have to play it as it goes. It's like old, dirty 6-pound test. Dirty from all the mud from the last few days, so I gotta not hork them here. I want to get my rig back. There's my braid hanging on the line right there. Lift up, baby. Don't go on the bottom. If I could just get this other line in my hand here, I could probably prevent a tangle by bringing it up to me while I'm fighting the fish and threading my... The fish is making this hard though, because... Shoot, I gotta keep tension on though. Don't want this to tangle up. That's my main priority. When braid gets tangled, it is really annoying. It's very difficult. It just cinches right up, even if it's just a loop and not a knot. But the carp's pulling out, so it's pulling the braid that way. Annoying. Really annoying. Come on. No. I just want this. Oh, there we go. Got it. I could just... There we go. That's all I wanted to do. That. Now I don't have a mess. Except for this. There we go. Awesome. It's off of my line. But it's still wound around me. Sweet. All right. I can focus on the fish. I'll get them in someday. Don't go that way again. It's not the good way to go. That's where that... Don't go that way, please. Got this guy in a nightcrawler, by the way. Probably guessed that though. That's all I have is nightcrawlers and shiners. And sometimes I hit live bait like shiners and stuff, and crankbaits and other and jigs, and had all that happen. But not usually. What if this was a catfish, man? That would be so awesome. That'd be a big cat. Well into the 30 inches class. For sure. I gotta believe. Probably just a small carp though. Pretty much. Yeah, he's not tired yet. Oh man, I think he crossed my line again. That's super annoying. No, turn around. Come on. Jeepers, come on. He's clipping on a ton of rocks and junk. Might eventually find like a snag or something, so I gotta... Wow, he's fighting harder now. If anything, definitely didn't tire him out that much. Oh man, yeah, he's clipping on the bottom a lot. That junk out there. Is my line again. He crossed it again when he went that way. I should have reeled it in and just set this grab. Two-handed it. Reeled that one in while I fought this guy. Now I got a mess again. Oh, that's so annoying. Putting a loop in my line too, the weight. That's the rig. He caught the rig itself, I guess. That's the weight dropping down, that's why it's so heavy. So annoying. No, this way, please. Come in. Already. Keeps catching on all sorts of junk down there. So the line could break. I'm trying to lift him up. So he doesn't clip on everything and ruin my line, you know, so because then it'll break off. If he starts clipping on, like, I don't know, stuff that would cut the line. Rocks, for example. I don't know. See how big he is. I'm guessing just decent, even though he's being a pain in the butt. Really fighting way too hard for just a decent carp. Doesn't feel that heavy though, that's why I say decent, at best, probably. Doesn't feel heavy at all. I turn him pretty easy, but he just has a lot of energy. Oh man. Not exactly a carp rig, just a little panfish rig. It's coming in now. Yeah, small carp. Not even decent, small sized. Oh. Small carp, probably 28 inches at the longest, I'd guess, or right around there.